future, talk radio will actually educate, inspire, and make you think. The future is now. Topics and music that affect your life. From Universal Broadcasting Network. Tune in at ubnradio.com.
Thank you for being
Boulevard.
Life is a banquet, and most poor suckers are starving to death.
I'd like to propose a toast.
This is On the Rocks with Alexander, coming at you from Sunset Gower Studios in the heart of Hollywood, where I drink with your favorite celebrities and we talk about fashion, entertainment, pop culture, reality TV, and that's about it. So pop a cork, pour a glass, lean back, and enjoy On the Rocks every Tuesday at 7 p.m. on Universal Broadcasting Network.
Fasten your seatbelts. It's going to be a bumpy night.
It's going to be a bumpy night. Anytime you have Naomi Grossman like on the panel, like I don't know who we're going to offend. How many followers can I lose tonight? This is On the Rocks. I am your hostess with the mostest, Alexander. You can find us here every Tuesday. We have to say hi to our listeners on Hillcrest Social. We're now streaming live on their Facebook. Hey, girls, or guys, or in-betweeners, probably. LGBTQUMNOP app. We have a full panel. We are covering the Golden Globes, and there are a lot of Golden Globes in here that we're going to talk about. But we're going to cover the outfits, the winners, the losers, everything. And so I have assembled the team, the expert panel. Mm-hmm. Right off the bat, coming back to the show, People Magazine's Patrick Gomez. Hey, girl.
Hey, girl. Hi.
Hey, girl. Hi. Now, like, you literally were tweeting me footage from the red carpet. Like, you were in the thick of it.
You got like a first person account in the moment.
Yes, there were some other photos you sent, which we won't talk about. But yes, so you were there. We're going to talk all about that. Also coming back to the show, a listener favorite. Not that you're not, but you know, we have from American Horror Story, Fear Incorporated, the chair. Miss Naomi Grossman. Hey, girl.
Hey, girl.
I just say, you and I have been having some fun times together. I have a picture. You and I went to Halloweeny. You went dressed as Hillary, and yeah. I went dressed as Hillary's cat, shall we say.
Her pussy.
Her pussy. We had so much fun. And then I think that night I came to your house, and we sang Jesus Christ Superstar in Cabaret until like 3 a.m.
Yeah.
You have a fabulous voice.
Is that,
now.
Is that the voice?
Yeah. Yes. Welcome, everybody.
It's lovely.
You are back on the show because your recap, you're just so wonderful.
Well, and that's why I didn't watch this year.
Good start, everybody.
Best way to recap.
Yes.
I just thought, you know, I got this.
You got it.
I can truly phone it in.
What I love is determining if a film is good or not before I've actually seen it from the trailer. That's what I love to do.
Well, see, unlike you, I've actually seen the movie.
Oh, okay.
Well, I just don't care about watching.
Then we're
going to
meet somewhere
drunk.
In the middle.
But
what?
That's your thing.
You don't
I know.
Like watching celebrities drunk? What are you doing here tonight?
Right. She said
celebrities.
Yeah.
Oh. Entertainment Weekly, here I come. But you have been traveling.
I have.
People need to go to your fan page, Naomi Grossman, because you post pictures from all your conventions that you go to. You literally are everywhere.
It's like Lonely Planet meets Planet of the Apes.
Speaking of which, you just came back from Cuba, so.
Have we already offended a group?
The Cubans.
How many groups
it's
have
It's not
we
like they have
yet?
Internet.
We need to be a drinking
apes. You offended game. Apes now.
Oh.
No, I've dated a few Cubans. Whew.
Yeah.
Breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
Ooh.
But literally, internet is so hard to find out that you sent me a picture.
Oh, God.
Like, there's people on the street
right.
trying to find internet.
There's like two city blocks you can actually, people gather. And I mean, I saw a guy actually with his computer in the middle of a street. Like, you know, if you point it just the right direction, like the stars align, you know, do a little dance, and like maybe you'll get online.
So
maybe.
What do people do with all their free time? Like, people actually have to, like, talk to each
other at
dinner.
They stand in line for bread.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, really? It's
yeah.
that dire? Because
no,
I heard it was,
yeah.
like, now some beautiful land.
Oh, it's beautiful. But, I mean, you know, when you're not admiring the landscape, when it's all you've seen your whole life because you can't leave, you stand in line for bread.
Maybe I should go there. I need to take a vacation from a few carbs.
Stand in line for carbs, yeah.
I have assembled this panel. It's turning against me.
No, you drink your carbs. It's okay.
That is literally true. If you took me out to dinner, you would be offended by how little I actually ate. I'd be like, vodka.
It's true. I don't think you ate at all at Halloweeny, which is how you wound so drunk.
You always say that, and you are as drunk as I am, Miss.
Well, as
you're, like, you're drunk. Let's have a party. Let's have a kiki. Like, great. Let's go back to 1999. Have a kiki. You are actually the most fun person to party with.
Oh, yeah. Thanks.
Yes.
It's because of my pantsuit. Everyone wants a picture.
Right. You were very popular that night.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, not so much November 9.
Don't get me started.
Sorry.
Briefly, you came out with a new acting reel, and I would like to share it. You know, we have such fun times and crazy times. I tend to forget what a consummate actress you are and how much you have moved. Your fans keep growing and growing. It's not like you did the role and stepped away.
Well, what, yeah, they were 12 them? Before, and now they're 15, yes. So yeah.
Carbs. let's take a look at your new reel, that fresh, hot off the press, off of this last week.
It was love at first sight.
When Jessica Lange is like the first line in your reel, that's a good thing.
Play with me.
Pepper. Here's a good one. Knock, knock, who's there? Arden. Arden who? Arden, you the quack who'd make a better duck.
I listen to this all the time, by the way.
I fought to keep that.
And you'll really feel sorry for yourself. I need to get you out of this thing. I have to put you in the decontamination shower.
And she's harmed in any way. There won't be anyone else to blame. They'll take you, open up your head, and stir your brain with a fork. And when you return,
he looks
you'll
scared.
Experience firsthand how
would you scare James Cromwell? Like, you're doing a good job.
You want to wait for that?
This, we need to decompress.
Check him. Easy.
You're just sexy in everything you do. Like, you're just sexy.
So sexy.
Men pay you a lot of money to do that in the privacy of their home.
We've gotten word of several terrorist attacks taking place throughout.
Love it. Love it. What a great reel. I love it. Also rounding out our panel, coming back to the show, we have celebrity stylist Rene Horsch.
Hey, how are you?
So we're going to share some of the pictures. You went to, in fact, you actually brought, I love when you guest on the show because you bring treats.
I always bring you some good booze, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. That's good how booze I roll, and good booze. Know? Like, yeah. You're just, like, everything is happening. So you actually brought us something.
Yeah. So Moet was the official sponsor for the Golden Globes for the 26th year in a row. And they also sponsored the Harvey Weinstein Netflix party. And so my best girlfriend works for LVMH, the Moet Hennessy side. So she hooked me up. And so these are the little ones that they actually serve everybody. So when you,
they're Weinstein bottles.
Yeah. So when you hit the red carpet, that's the first thing. The Moet girls, they hand you these. It's great. They want to get you liquored up and loaded.
Yep.
And
I had a Moet man hand me mine on the carpet.
Oh, you did. So you got the
Moet, actual Moet men?
Yeah, they've got men and women. It's great.
Was he wearing, like, a tuxedo in the whole bit? Or was he, like, in a Moet t-shirt? Do they even wear t-shirts? No? It's like a cashmere shirt or something.
Yeah, the girls are... A caftan, actually, is what it was.
Yeah, the girls are all in evening gowns. The guys are all in their tuxedos. So, yeah.
Sexy.
They could do it shirtless next year. I think that'd be good, right?
Let's class it up, sweetie.
Right.
but literally, and we have pictures. You attended your dates for the evening. I mean, Donna Mills.
Oh, yeah.
And
she's
Lisa
gorgeous,
Rinna.
Huh?
So do you know how many comments, because people know that you're on the show, and so people message me like, Donna Mills looks amazing.
She looked fantastic.
She looks amazing. Yeah. She's like radiant.
She. I mean, her body is off the charts. She just turned 76.
No
way. Isn't she amazing? Wow. Yeah.
That's crazy. Yeah. Look at that dress, and look at you.
Oh, smoke and mirrors. That's what I say.
No, sweetie, you always look amazing. I could see you at like pavilions on a Sunday morning, and you'd be like in La Croix.
No, not looking good. No. yeah, no, we had a great time, and that was, she's wearing Mark Zanino, and Lisa Rinna's wearing Mark Zanino as well. So, yeah.
Lisa Rinna fits clothes, whether she's in sweats or anything. She just fits it so well.
Talk about a body, that body. And she pushed two kids out with that body. It's crazy.
I still think she had a surrogate. I think Harry Hamlin pushed out those kids.
Yeah, right.
She wears the pants. We know.
She ordered them off of QVC. You know, they just came one day. Yeah.
She's great on QVC.
Yeah, she is really good.
But your styling, like you work with them, but they really become your friends. And we've talked about this. It's your demeanor. It's who you are. But they like, can I just name drop?
Sure, name drop.
You've been hanging out with a certain dame a lot lately.
A very long time. Yeah. God, you know, we go back, I'm going to date myself, but we go back almost 30 years. So I met her on Dynasty. I got an internship with Nolan Miller. That's how I got
you
to
interned
meet
on
Dynasty. Yeah, actually the last season.
Can you imagine getting that job as young gay man? Intern on Dynasty? Yeah, girl.
Yeah, so I scored on that really, really well. And then after my internship, then Nolan hired me as an assistant. And then the rest is history. It just kind of climbed the ladder at Nolan Miller. And, you know, we did Melrose Place and 90210 and anything Aaron Spelling, you know, Nolan and Aaron were anything that Aaron produced, Nolan did the direction for. So, yeah, good times. But, yeah, so anyway, so Joan and I, we go way, way back. And so now.
You go to her house.
In Saint-Tropez.
Saint-Tropez.
And her house, and she's got a home in London, and she has a home in New York, and then she's got her place here in L.A. So, yeah, no, she's a lot of fun. She's a good time. And then we were at she was at the Harvey Weinstein party as well. And
she looked fabulous.
Yeah, she looked really great. She's 83. So yeah.
But this is what's happening with Hollywood. I had the benefit. In fact, we're going to be airing the episode later. I interviewed Tippi Hedren earlier today.
Oh yeah.
She's in her 80s, and in fact, it's her birthday. She looked flawless.
She looks great.
And it's the energy that they have too. It's like I barely have that energy now. Right.
But you know who else was like that? Was Joan Rivers. Joan Rivers. She came.
These
to
are
our
professionals. Yeah. That they know what their job is, and mm-hmm. they do their job.
She came to. Yeah. She came to the Marcolino Atelier. They actually shot an episode. This is back in 2012. They shot an episode of Joan Knows Best, her reality show with Melissa.
Yeah.
And it was so funny. So the whole day they were there shooting and everything, and like it was like 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and everybody was taking a break. And Joan, you know, Joan was like, "All right," she's like, "Come on, everybody." And she's clapping her hands. She's like, "Look at my staff." She's like, "They're half my age and they're already wiped out." She's like, "Come on, people, let's go." And her energy level was off the charts. It was really it's very inspiring, you know.
Well, last time I was here, Tony Basil was here. She was like,
she's like 70, right?
Yeah, going on.
Yeah, and she looked flawless.
20, right? Yeah, right.
I just interviewed Rita Moreno, and she.
Oh yeah, she's another one.
Like
yeah.
I interviewed, so she's on the new Netflix One Day at a Time.
Yes.
And oh, is she?
It's all Hispanics, by the way.
Yeah.
I.
Yeah, there you go. And
I'm still
and
not the, on Netflix. Just want to know.
And the kids on the show are like, you know, 13 and 17, I think, and they were like, we would be like, you know, like just on the floor, exhausted after a long day, and she would like come around the corner, ready for another take, dancing and getting them up, being like, let's go. Like they were like, she had 10 times more energy than any of us did.
It's crazy.
It's from the same cloth. Like Angela Lansbury at her age was doing 8 shows a week. Carol Channing will still do Hello Dolly if you ask her to.
Yeah.
And I think it really comes from
her. And she's doing it right this second.
She's literally in Rancho
Mirage.
Somewhere
in this world right now.
Raspberry.
She is doing Hello Dolly.
Yes.
Diamond Jar Girl's best friend.
She's standing by for Bette Midler, I'm telling you. She's waiting in the wings. She's like, come on, bitch. Take a night off.
But you know what? Joan Collins, I tell everybody, she's like running around in Jimmy Choo stilettos with the pointed toe. She's not wearing granny shoes. She's not in orthopedics. The woman, she bounces out of a chair. I never hear her saying, oh, my back. Or I never hear her complain.
Because even if they were in pain,
they're
would not complain about it.
Yeah.
That's the whole Hollywood class. You know, we cater to these, God, I'm dating myself by saying MTV stars, but now it's CW stars.
Yeah.
You know, and I've interviewed some of them. And you know, there's so much work involved, and then they get tired, and they can only do this and all that. And then you have professionals like Tippi Hedren comes in. She's like, okay, let's do the show. Let's talk for an hour and a half.
Yeah.
And it's just part of the job, and it's part of that professionalism.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. It's inspiring, and because I have people give me grief, like, why are you always running around with Dame Joan Collins? I said, well, she's
why not?
She's kicks and giggles, and
you don't need that negativity in your life.
Right? Thank you.
You cut them loose.
I'm like, are you kidding? And like we walk in everywhere, and the doors open, and she's, you know, and especially in Saint-Tropez, she's like, do you see why I like it here? Because they all bow down to her over there. Because in Europe, she's, you know, she's a really extra big deal over there, you know.
She's a dame.
Yeah, she's
there's
a dame.
There's nothing like a dame.
That's right.
See what you did there.
Mm-hmm. I call her DJC, you know, for
DJC. Dame. Yeah. I'm sure she loves
it. She likes that, yeah. And she thinks it sounds kind of cool. You know, hey, DJ C, what's up, girl?
Yeah. DJ C.
It's like J Lo.
Right?
Yeah. Yes, yes.
DJ C.
Yeah. I get J Lo. I don't get J Law.
I get Negro. Oh, drink.
Yeah. Oh, drink.
Yes. Oh, yeah. Anytime, Naomi Grossman. Yes. It's all somebody drink. To round out our panel, and Miss Kate Kneeland, you are new to our show. You've never been here.
I'm new. Brand
I am
new.
So sorry. My apologies.
I'm a virgin. I'm a virgin on this panel.
Because you live in Atlanta, Georgia.
Yes. I do, you guys.
But
it's
your
true.
Roles, you're in the new film, and I love McDonald's, and I'm just going to put it. They could tell me the chickens are made out of babies, and I'll still eat the nuggets. Like, mm-hmm. I just will. They're so delicious. Are mm-hmm. you kidding? Does anybody... who am I talking
way,
to?
By the way, they're using real chicken right now. So, I mean, did you not see the press? It's real.
Real chickens.
Chicken.
They're fancy chickens.
It's real chicken.
I thought it was all chicken parts. Like, no, like smashed together, right?
It's real chicken.
It's real chicken. It might be the chicken foot, but it's real
it's
chicken.
Real there chicken. You go. Yeah, 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 yeah.
It still tastes luxurious.
No, I will say McDonald's breakfast... I would eat that every day. The burgers, all that kind of stuff, I don't need. But
don't
give me a good.
I don't wake up till 2 in the afternoon. So this whole breakfast thing is lost.
Well, now they have
me.
Breakfast every day, all
it's
day.
It's breakfast all day.
And now Atlanta has had biscuits since the beginning, but LA only had the
Look
egg
at Patrick
muffins.
Gomez knows all this. How are yeah. you so skinny and you know all this?
Oh, because I enjoy a good biscuit. I'm a Southern boy.
Okay, but Patrick, if you really want to get down on some biscuits, okay, just to be honest, you got to hit your Hardee's because
Hardee's
biscuits
we call
are better.
Hardee's Carl's Jr. out here.
Oh, okay, sorry, Carl's
yeah,
Jr.
Right. Midwest, right?
Yes.
Just got to look for the little star.
Yeah, yes. Just look for that star and know that the biscuits are really good.
Biscuits are great at Hardee's, and also they're cookies because they're not like fully cooked. God, you guys, I'm... anyway,
what about Kentucky Fried Chicken? Do you like that?
No. Isn't that weird?
Really?
No. Wow. I can't do it. Nope.
Popeyes. Churches.
I've never had any of this.
How about Ross's waffles and chicken? Right?
Roscoe's. Roscoe's. They yeah. actually went
I'm
bankrupt.
Sure Ross
they're
has some
closing.
Good chicken, right? too. Yeah.
You guys, they closed Formosa Cafe.
I what? Heard that.
When?
That's
horrible. Oh,
that's
no way.
Awful.
Like,
that's
secretly.
What are we talking about?
It's like, it's actually an iconic spot in Hollywood. They have pictures on it. And it's when you went... When you wanted to be seen but not be seen, you're like, oh, you recognize me? You know, it's dark, but it was so classy. In fact, we did a cast party when you were at Celebration mm-hmm. Theater in that musical. That's when I first noticed you.
What musical?
It was called The Next Fairy Tale.
He was in tights.
Oh, really?
That is true.
Well.
I remember.
But yeah, Formosa was legendary, and it is a sad thing.
And they closed it, like, secretly. Like, they just all of a sudden, it was like, it's been closed
no
for a week.
Away party.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah. So the staff showed up and was like, huh, apparently I don't work today.
Like, March was like, a goddamn 45 is my years of service, and now I'm out of it.
Yeah.
But speaking of McDonald's and fast food, this is what I'm getting. You are part of this film, and it's highly anticipated, and I cannot wait to see it. You know, Michael Keaton has had a great comeback, and I'll be honest, I've never been a Michael Keaton fan, but his Birdman thing, that was a good film. Mm-hmm. It was a really good film.
It's
it was different,
film.
It was well-acted, and the ensemble was so great. And for the first time, he didn't annoy me. And so he's in The Founder, which is about McDonald's, and you play a huge part of McDonald's history.
Yes, I play June Martino, who was his secretary and assistant for many years, Ray Kroc. And Ray Kroc struggled a long time before he became the man known as McDonald's.
Well, he was selling like milkshake machines, right?
Oh, yeah.
And we know McDonald's milkshake machine is always down.
I mean, he was a door-to-door salesman. Yeah, he was a door-to-door salesman. And he was always trying to find that like next quick big money maker. And at the time that she was working for him, it was the multi-mixers. And then things changed rapidly. So,
wow.
What was it like being on set? Everybody feel.
Well, I just want to know, did you meet my friend, John Carroll Lynch?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, my God. He's amazing.
Yeah,
he's
is.
Fantastic. I don't have any scenes with the McDonald's brothers because I'm sort of Ray Kroc's, you know, person. Yeah.
You're like her
and,
girl,
I mean,
girl
I
Friday.
Bitch about the McDonald's brothers, you know, with Ray.
Right.
So there's that. But I did get to, you know, obviously I got to hang out with all those guys.
We'll
but
take
John
a
Carroll
selfie
is...
and text it to him.
Okay, yes.
Make him very
let's,
jealous,
let's
I'm sure.
Let's definitely do that.
Are you in town for the premiere tomorrow?
Yes.
That's what she's here for.
Yeah. I'm here for that and, you know, hoping
and this,
to...
Obviously.
Yeah, and this.
What are you wearing?
This, when, I mean...
Oh, yeah, what are you wearing to the premiere?
Adrian Papel, am I saying it wrong? I'm saying it wrong. The stylist
she
is
so
looking
adorable.
At me.
You guys, she is so adorable right now.
So what color?
It's silver beaded. Nice. It's really beautiful.
Oh, I hope it's not Nicole Kidman's dress.
No, God no.
That was terrible. It just looks.
Well, first of all, we'll get to it. You know, I would be considered by Hollywood standards your curvy athletic.
curvy athletic. Oh my God, you guys! Hashtag curvy athletic. I love it.
Or you know, so whatever. I'm ample.
I'm Gilbert Grape in Hollywood. Whatever. Okay.
I'm an ample Grape. Girl in Hollywood. So yeah, you don't want to see. Skin poking through things, you don't want to
Yeah, but
see
you know
that.
What? Has Hollywood like we'll talk about this, but has Hollywood gotten more accepting?
Yes,
like Octavia
I think
Spencer
so.
Was
yes.
in a tight tuxedo.
Yeah,
yep. This Is Us features an overweight woman.
Also, my friend Chrissy Metz.
She's
she
fantastic.
Was on American Horror Story. As well.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm.
Sorry, I just
she was.
Yeah,
she was the fat lady. No, that's not. I'm not that's offending like the, any groups.
That's oh, like that was her title.
For once,
that was her
that
title.
Was her actual
that's
actual
sure.
character
play.
Name.
That's a character.
And I will say, she was an agent.
Really?
Yeah, she was an agent and working in an agency. She was my friend's agent back in the day. Uh-huh. She was working at an agent at the agency. The call, the casting notice came out, and she was like, "We don't have anyone that's like that plus size other than me." She'd acted like back in the day, had given it up because there wasn't really roles for her.
Wow.
She auditioned for that one, got it, and then obviously that's led to.
Wow.
Led to
talk
everything.
About great
that's
voice.
Great.
To
so
be
it.
Famous, I have to become an agent, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Okay. All right.
That's the path. You start as an uh-huh. agent, and then you.
I just don't like other people that much. Like, I don't think I could work for other people.
I don't think any of my agents.
Or just be your own agent. Elliot Gould said the first role that he ever got, he called pretending to be some famous agent.
I think that happens a lot. I get calls to book people. And then I go to their Facebook, and it's like, oh, they have 157 followers, but their PR person called. Yeah,
Donald Trump did that to People Magazine.
I didn't want to talk about that.
Called in, pretending to be his publicist.
How about Meryl's speech? Was that fantastic?
We're gonna play it later.
Okay,
We're gonna play it.
We're jumping ahead.
Okay, sorry.
You know, this show is very structured.
Okay.
Kate, what was it like being on set though? You know, there has to be a certain energy for it because it was anticipated before you guys actually started filming. Were you nervous? Were you just like, oh, okay?
Yeah, I was more excited than nervous, and I honestly honored to get to play somebody who is a very important
huge
historical
part, right?
Female figure in, you know, business. I mean, she's one of the first great female entrepreneurs, and so, you know, to get to play that was amazing. And, you know, to work with Michael Keaton, because almost every single scene is just me and Michael Keaton.
How is he on set? Like, what's his approach? Does he like a lot of takes? Does he like one take? Do you like a lot of takes or do you like one take?
Well, you know, I mean, I think I'm like every actor. I have a side that I prefer to be filmed at all times. No,
they all
I'm
are
just,
that way, aren't they?
I'm kidding. Right?
She's very mad she has that chair over there. She's like, I wanted to be over in your chair.
So, yeah.
No, all that female, I mean, all my clients, all those old divas, they all have their side. It's crazy.
But, you know, it's just smart. Even like when we took pictures with Tippi today, she knew how to stand, how to turn her body.
Because the studio
it's
taught them.
Smart.
They know how
you
to
know
get
me,
out
I'm just like.
No, I totally agree. I mean, I don't have any of that. I come from a theater background. So for me, it's just.
In theater, we're just like balls to the wall. Here we are.
And just tell me where my mark is, and that's, you know, that's where I'll go. And I'll, so as far as like how many takes, I, you know, as many as the director asks for, that's what I do. But I mean, Michael is, he's very focused. I mean, he knows what he wants, and not in like a rude way or anything, but he's very collaborative too. So it's like, hey, you know, why don't we try this? Or I think it would make more sense if we did it this way. And, you know, he would talk about, like, what kind of relationship June and Ray probably had. And, yeah, I mean, I thought it was an amazing experience.
Wasn't the first McDonald's, I'm sorry to interrupt, but didn't it start in San Bernardino?
Yes.
It did, right?
Yes.
Is the original
the only good
still,
thing to come out of San
yeah,
Bernardino.
Yeah, right? Is
I
it
mean,
still
honestly,
out there?
It's
got, like, the
yes,
gold. It has, like, two golden arches, right?
You can go see it.
Is it on the way to Palm Springs?
Yeah, I guess so, because San Bernardino's on the way out there.
I know
there.
It
yeah,
well.
Yeah. Oh, have you been to that one?
I asked for more sweet and sour sauce, and they wanted to charge me. I'm like, did you make this yourself? Like, can you give me some?
But you may have actually seen the one, you know, in the end, because there was such animosity between Ray Kroc and the McDonald's
And
brothers.
I didn't even know this.
Yeah. What you may actually see now is the first McDonald's is the building, the land he brought literally across the street from where theirs was. And in the final settlement that he had with them, they couldn't call themselves McDonald's anymore. They couldn't even use their golden arches. They had to change the shape of the M that they used. I mean, he drove them out of business. As so the one that you're seeing is sort of the first one, but not...
Okay.
I mean, so, it's certainly been there.
So Kroc actually stole it from the McDonald's brothers?
Yeah.
Yes.
Wow. No, you got to see the movie.
I've seen it. I saw the movie.
You guys, honestly,
well, we're going to play the trailer.
Is that he, you are rooting for him. You're rooting for him in the beginning.
I think that's under, I've had things stolen from me.
And then all of a sudden you're like, oh, you know how when, I'm not stealing anything from you. I mean, I might.
Oh, you're starting your own podcast tomorrow. I know. On the Rocks.
I'm stealing the show.
On the Rocks ish.
No, but it's
I'm going to call it Martinis and Dish. That's what I'll call mine.
God, why did I think of that? Naomi, how many takes did you do for your big pepper moment? And we've told our listeners, you know, your big emotional, it had Emmy nomination buzz around it. And you got the script literally like a couple of days before and had to
12
prepare
hours.
For 12 hours before. How many takes did you do? Was it?
I mean, it's the same thing. You do it as much as the director thinks. And, you know, when he says, we got it, that's, yeah, you got to trust.
Yeah.
But as an actress, do you keep it knowing that the first take is never going to be used?
Not necessarily.
That's not necessarily true. Oh, okay. I mean, you don't, you know, they never say, I'm not led on many film sets. After the first take.
Kicked off of, though.
Yeah. I've heard no stories of like, thanks, one take. All right, we're good. Moving on. But, you know... It's entirely possible that they'll use that person.
But I mean,
you just trust that they have gotten whatever it is that they...
Well, and coming from the theater, though, it is hard because in the theater, you feel it after a performance.
Exactly. And Patrick, you in the theater, too.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah.
But on screen, you know, like, you may kill it in, like, you know, one line and then it falls flat the next or whatever, but... And instead of worrying about the whole thing, like, being a comprehensive, awesome whole... They're going to cut it apart anyway.
Yeah,
so what does
it
matter?
They are. So
but that's
just,
the one thing I find frustrating in the times that I've done camera acting is that you can have a great sense of your pacing in a scene, but then you see it edited and it could be better, could be worse, but like it's just completely different. And you're just like, oh, there's no correlation between theater and screen acting in that sense because...
Right. Well, that's why you have to make best friends with the editors because they
the cinematographers.
And lighting. It's all about lighting.
That is absolutely true.
Right?
Get those lighters and the cinematographer and the editors to be like, hey, guys.
Yeah.
And you bring donuts to the set and make friends with everybody, right? Mm-hmm. That's what you do, right?
Yeah. Yes.
But like in the 40s and 50s, a lot of the editors were women. Yeah. And they really had like a woman's eye, not to be sexist, but they really shaped.
You have a woman's eye. Just one, though.
No, it's a lazy eye.
No, that's the man eye.
I've never met a lazy woman, so...
Is it just the mascara?
It's a Mexican
it's
eye.
It's the one eye. It's the mascara.
Katie reading me.
I like your smoky eye looks really good tonight. Yeah.
It really does.
Looking
I feel
good.
Like Liza Minnelli after a night at Studio 54.
What you were saying about that first take thing, Joan Collins and Donna, they both did soap opera after they did their, you know, Knots Landing and Dynasty. Right. And Joan and Donna both said, they said on soap opera, you get one take and maybe two at the most, and they move.
Soap opera is a whole different
thing. Oh, you can mess up the line. I've heard on soaps, and you can literally just have set a line that makes no sense, and they're like, great, moving on.
No, because they said their budgets are low, and they have to keep moving quickly. And Joan Collins said...
Well, they're on a tighter time.
Yeah.
I've had soap opera actors, and they literally have to do like 12 scenes a day.
Yeah, Joan said she had a whole new respect for like soap opera actors. She said that they actually have to work hard because it moves so quickly, and when they did Dynasty, she said that we had the luxury they would just shoot one scene a day, and they would like, you know, it moves so much slower.
And here's the thing about soap opera actors too: the audience is so interactive. If you mess up on a day that you think, okay, let's just get the scene out, they're going to call you out on that scene, and they're going to tweet at you and whatever. Like, their fans are crazy. When you do a film, and maybe it's not the best, whatever, you're not going to really hear about it. You know what I mean?
No, yeah.
So we're going to watch the trailer of the Founder.
Great.
Oh, yeah.
Yay.
Thank you, Kurt. He's straight, so it takes a little bit longer.
I know what you're thinking. How the heck does a 52-year-old, over-the-hill milkshake machine salesman build a fast food empire with 1,600 restaurants at an annual revenue of $700 million? One word. Persistence.
Queen's Castle Sales.
Hi, Jim.
Ray, how's it going down there?
Good. Swell. A lot of interest.
we got an order. 6 mixers.
To anyone in particular?
McDonald's.
Care for a little tour?
We wanted something different, and that's when my brother here comes up with one of his brilliant ideas.
Orders ready in 30 seconds, not 30 minutes.
Unique, original, there's nothing like this.
It's revolutionary.
It's exactly what it is. It's revolutionary. What is that?
The golden arches.
It's a way to make the place stand out.
Huh. There should be McDonald's everywhere. Franchise the damn thing.
Mr. Krug.
Franchise, franchise, franchise.
McDonald's can be the new American church.
I do hear a little Beetlejuice in it, though, I have to say.
Boys.
I am flesh, like Jack Nicholson.
Love this trailer, by the
capital.
Way.
Did you mortgage our home?
We could lose everything.
I want to renegotiate my lousy deal.
I can't.
Can't or won't?
Ray.
What?
No!
Oh, damn it.
What you ought to be doing is owning the land upon which that burger is cooked. You're not in the burger business. You're in the real estate business.
Boom.
Franchise
Smart.
Corporation.
It's its own separate company, which puts it outside your purview.
There's a wolf in the hen house. We let him in.
When's enough going to be enough for you?
Probably never.
You are to stop this instant.
I am through taking orders from you.
You have a contract.
Contracts are like hearts. They're made to be broken. Business is war. It's dog eat dog, rat eat rat. I want to take the future. I want to win.
The brothers are your business partners.
Make it go away. I don't care what it takes.
That glorious name, McDonald's. I had to have it.
You don't have it. You sure about that?
I love the trailer. And look at you being all up in Michael Keaton's shiz.
I love it. What years is it? Like 1950s, right?
Well, it kind of it follows several years. It starts in the late 50s and moves through the 60s.
Oh, yeah. Wow. Mm-hmm. Cool.
And I love when she says, when is enough enough? No.
Yeah.
Because we're all artists here. Mm-hmm. There's never enough. And the minute you think you're enough,
it's true.
That's when your art suffers, right?
Right.
Like when you start believing it.
But wait, are we talking about art or hamburgers?
I could talk about hamburgers all night long.
All of the above.
I'm going to start a new podcast about hamburgers.
And chicken parts.
Chicken.
Because when enough is enough. It's real chicken now, okay? They wouldn't say that if it wasn't true. I mean, look at where, you guys.
Why can't they give you more sauce with the nuggets? I swear.
They can. It's just 50 cents.
But why? It's not like
girl, you got 50 cents.
If I was working at McDonald's, I'd like unload the truck.
Now where we just say what's true all the time.
No, because you'll get admonished.
Nobody's
for
lying. Yeah, nobody.
You can only say if you're Meryl Streep, you can say whatever you want.
Yes, that's true.
I have to welcome our usual cast of characters. Kurt, our engineer, makes us look good.
Kurt, yeah.
Y'all just blew out my ears.
Sorry.
Yeah. So you know, good job, Kurt. You know, we have to give straight people a voice in entertainment. So, Kurt.
I've been saying that for years.
Yes.
They are at times the minority.
You have a family and everything, too.
I know. And I feel like...
You have children?
Yes, I do.
Oh, wow. That's amazing.
Have they
no one in L.A. has those. No one can afford them.
We know you're from Atlanta.
We can't afford to house them is the issue more than anything.
Can I really be honest? If you go to my Facebook, Alexander Rodriguez, I said, if you friend request me and you have a cat or a child in your profile pic... Not gonna accept.
You're not gonna
but that's gonna change gonna now. But what if
it's a
met
kitten?
One of us.
It's a baby.
You've met one
it's a
of
kid
us.
Child.
I
kid
can
cat.
Represent people.
Well,
with
you're
a child.
You're cool.
It's one child.
But I think if your kids were here, it would be less cool.
Yeah.
No offense. I'm sure they're beautiful, wonderful children. Anyway, back to straight people in entertainment. Kurt, do you have a pun for us?
I do.
We have
actually.
To give him this moment. Yes.
Okay.
Or he turns off all the microphones.
Exactly. Did I ever tell you I used to work at a hospital?
Why, Kurt?
I got sick of it.
But I'm bummed.
Oh, God, Kurt.
Actually, Patrick actually gave you like a genuine laugh.
I love puns. I mean, the cheesiest pun.
Do you really?
I, like, dad
he
humor.
Does the worst.
Dad humor is my favorite.
Kurt, give us another one for Patrick.
Okay, come on.
Okay, well, you put me on. This is more spotlight than I'm used
to. He's going
to
take that karaoke mic to the hill.
Come on, straight people. Yeah. Make us proud.
I don't trust the stairs.
Why?
They're always up to something.
Oh.
See, I like them.
Oh,
you've got a good one.
Laughing.
I like yours.
You do like them, don't you?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
This is a legitimate laugh.
They kind of hurt a little bit. I feel like you die a little bit every time.
He did these puns to Joanne Worley, by the way, and Joanne was like, I don't know what to do with that.
She was secret, you just need me here.
Exactly.
Joanne Worley, didn't she like these? Joanne Worley.
She has ears. No.
Oh, okay.
She wanted to give him a whirly.
Did she pet you? Is that what she did? She was like,
she actually gave me this glass from her private collection. It's On the Rocks glass from the 60s, and there's actual rocks in it.
Oh, I love that.
Thank you, Joanne Worley.
I didn't know that's where that came from.
Yes, of course.
That's very cool. Also, of course. I don't know why I didn't assume.
Also, every week, we have our Girl Friday. Mom, pay attention. Can you look up?
Hello, Mamala.
Oh, so now you're remembering me.
Yes, Mama Rose, 12 hours of labor, we know. She actually, no joke, had to drive herself to the hospital.
What?
Why? Where was your dad? Oh, you're Mexican.
True story, hashtag true story.
I kind of get that in there. I've been slacking.
I've met my dad a few times. He's okay. Mom, look up from the phone.
Here we go.
Anyway, Mom, thank you for womaning our chat room. She's on the chat room on Facebook and on ubnradio.com. You can message her your questions, and if it's a fun comment, a burning question, she will bring it to the show. Mom.
Can she also let us know, like, the worst things?
She's looking good tonight. Yeah, her game is on. Yeah.
Honestly, we're talking about age. If I told you her age, you would not believe it.
Well, let's not talk about age.
62.
Wow.
Really?
Wow. Looking good, Mama. Your game is on.
Yeah, you look great.
Yeah.
61.
She's like, don't push it. Don't push it.
No, but honestly, my mom and I grew up as best
friends. I thought you were
close
with your mom. I thought you were close with her.
We like this.
But I do feel like at a certain age, it would be like nice to start saying you are old. Like being like, I'm 84 and you're 60, because then like everyone would be like, you look so good. Right?
My
it's like you almost
want to
lie
that.
In the other direction.
Go 10 years up, right?
Yeah.
No, age up. I just traveled with my mom.
And you took a lot of pictures.
Oh,
NaomiGrossman.com.
She literally had like a harem of men that were just, I mean, like bros.
It's because they came to say hi to you. Let's be honest. You are a man's delight.
Straight men don't get it. Not like y'all. I mean, they do. Don't get me wrong. I get mine. But
yes,
I'm
do.
Just saying.
People jump off bridges for you.
That's
literally.
True. Oh, my God. We got to talk about that.
Can I just say real fast? Naomi dated a man who threw himself off a bridge, and he was in a coma for like 3 months. I'm not even kidding you.
And then we were obviously separated for 14 years until the last time I was here. Do you remember?
Yep,
he was blowing up my phone. Yep. He woke me up this morning.
Oh, so it all worked out in the end?
I wouldn't go that far.
Like,
I'm not
all
like
the love
Atlanta
stories
or anything.
Anyway, Mom, thank you for...
He fell for you.
Mom,
see?
Oh,
I like
that
good
before.
Pun. Mom, thank you for warming your chat room. So you have a sign behind you. Yes, we can. Is that, yes,
that
you can loan
Obama
me a down payment for...
Good.
Oh, yes.
It was a good speech.
Oh.
We don't like to be political on the show, but I have to say... It's like when a really good show closes and there's nothing to take its place.
Yeah.
So, Mom, we're recapping the Golden Globes. What is your overall comment about the Golden Globes? Yeah. All right, sweetie. So if you have a burning question, message Mama Rose and she'll come on the air and she'll talk about it. So, and Mom, we can see you. One time she fell asleep during the show.
That is not true. I never
she
did.
She literally
did. Just like, her jokes were just putting me to, you know.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Mom. She gets, okay.
I love it. I like that laugh track. Yeah.
What laugh track? That was all of us. It was so funny.
We are going to start this recap. We're going to start from the red carpet and we're going to move on through the show. But I need our listeners to kind of know where the show is going.
Okay.
And so we're going to play footage from Dame Elizabeth Taylor.
Oh, yeah.
Her Golden Globes. Okay. Because this
not
is
from
really
this Golden Globes.
No. Naomi was like, oh, she did a great job. No, she's dead.
Was that 2008 or 6?
I would have watched it. I know she'd be on.
That might have been even earlier than 6.
She was on Paranormal Lockdown.
A lot of people would have watched if they knew she was.
That might have been like 2003. When was Gladiator?
Gladiator.
Oh, yeah. Gladiator.
It was.
All right, go ahead and play it. This is how tonight's going to go. Look at her hair, number one.
Thank you very much. Throughout the evening, we've seen clips from the 6 nominated films. Now,
she was at the bar.
It's time to find out which one
they all are.
Will take home.
She was at the Moet Pharmacy.
But she deserves to be this way.
Once again.
Good for her.
Yes.
Here are the nominees. Let me see.
She's reading.
For the motion picture drama.
The music scares her, by the way. Everybody's shouting.
What? I don't open this. I just read it from up there. I know it did.
I love Here Comes Mr. Golden Globe.
Yeah, what's he going to do?
He's like,
oh, Catherine. Catherine Mannheim's just like, oh, Cameron. Silly girl.
Cameron.
What?
Sweet. Cameron.
Hello. Cameron, sorry. Cameron.
We don't want to I read lose it from the here. Suspense.
What is oh, Dick Clark when he had a personality. First.
Was he hosting? Oh, what was his?
Producing, right?
Elizabeth.
Oh, yeah.
Billy Elliot.
She has no idea who these people are.
She's like, who are they?
She didn't see a single one of the films. She didn't see a single one. She's like,
they're all named too. Actually, Billy Elliot, Aaron Brockovich. She's probably like, I thought I was doing the movie, not the actors.
She could say Brockovich. She was actually glad it was a one word.
Sunshine.
I never even saw that film.
I've never even heard of it. Yeah.
Traffic.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I remember that. Yeah.
That was just a depressing
Wonder movie. Boys. And the winner is.
This is my favorite.
Flashing envelope.
Let's all say it together.
Gladiator!
I will say, even funnier than that, though, was Molly Shannon doing her on SNL. Like,
oh,
that's what I have in my
was
head.
That the, when they said that was, she was calling the lotto numbers.
Yes.
And she was like 14, 21, then she's like 7, and then she goes, S.
Yes, awesome. All right, so we're going to start with the red carpet. Thank you, Kurt.
How Thanks, aggressive. Kurt. Oh, that was awesome.
Renee's going to walk us through the red carpet, and we're all going to comment on what we think, because Yay. You actually made some choices that I was
You were
not,
like, not so good?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
But
all
first
right,
of all, I want to know, what red carpet show do we watch? Because I feel when, like, network, like ABC or NBC, when they run the red carpet, it's like the nerdy kids at the cool kids party. They don't know what to do with these celebrities. Like, J-Law, right?
Clearly you watch People's.
Okay, so I'm just going to confess it now because I was in Atlanta when this happened a few days ago.
Eating Hardee's?
No, I wasn't.
Getting those biscuits?
Yes.
Right?
You guys, I'm so hungry for biscuits right now.
Do you put gravy on your biscuits?
No.
What do you do?
No.
No, really?
No.
I was supposed to do like biscuits and gravy.
I mean, you
right?
can do biscuits
you can
gravy,
do that, but
right?
it's gross.
What happened?
Okay, thank she's you. Like, thank you for like, getting right to it.
Yes.
Okay. I watched the NBC version, okay?
It's horrifying.
Well, yeah, especially
that whole Today Show crowd.
The Today Show crowd, like
first I said,
of all,
it's the nerds, it's the like, cool it's, kids.
Yeah,
those,
hidden fences, you guys. Hidden fences, not a movie.
But that wasn't the first.
But he
wasn't.
No,
Michael Keaton.
No, that was the first mistake. Then Michael Keaton did it.
And then my favorite too was Al Roker interviewing Mel Gibson.
And he's like 300 years old, right?
Yeah. Since you directed. And
my popularity.
Well, yeah. I mean, what's changed in directing since your last film? And he said, you know, for example, the film, and Mel Gibson's just standing there. You know what? I'm sorry. I just can't think of anything. And Mel Gibson was like, just choose one.
Okay, but here's the thing.
He couldn't pick one?
He couldn't pick one.
Oh, he's
he
such a buffoon, though. He irritates me in the morning, you know?
Well,
I can't
watch
that.
He was
that.
Against the whole right? Meryl Streep speech and all that. And it's like, oh, I guess you can only give your opinion when you're drunk in a police car, right?
Mm-hmm.
But we're not political.
But we're just drunk
thing.
In police cars.
Yeah.
We know what to do in a police car.
Oh, I do. But then I watched the E, and what is missing, and Patrick, I want you to talk about this, what's missing is personality in the red carpet. Why is it not okay to say, that outfit doesn't ring true to me? Everybody's
because only Joan could
ass.
Get away with it.
Joan Rivers is the only one who could do it, right?
But why? It's like every outfit's the best. Every movie is the best. No, it's not.
Well, I mean, Kathy Griffin, who is Joan
really
Rivers,
think,
like,
do you really
could
think
get away.
The red
he gets
carpet,
away with what she
wow,
used to do.
Wow, you're nominated.
It. Yeah.
We thought it was a real piece. But,
well, I was
you know,
saying,
no,
I tweeted.
But it could be like Flash. Oh, let's look at this look. That's not right. I would never say that to somebody's face. but like a look.
You're like, what were you thinking? How did you pick this out, right?
Or I'd be like, you know, this outfit's not my favorite because of this and this. Not about the person, but like, right. We need more personality on the red carpet. Am I wrong? Naomi, let's you and I do the red carpet.
Listen, I have been on the, no, I have been on the worst dress list at the Emmys.
Oh, no.
I was.
Right. I don't think that's a bad thing, though. Because you're on a list.
Hey.
You're on a list.
Bad press is good press, right?
I remember, though. I mean, there's a lot of competition. But literally, I remember it was like 1,000 degrees.
It's always hot or raining.
The Emmys is always hot. Emmys is always hot. The Golden Globes is always freezing. This was a very, very nice. This was my fifth Golden Globe. It was the only. I remember one year standing on the carpet, and you wouldn't even want people to stop to talk to you because they would come and they'd be like, "Yeah, yeah, I'm here to promote." Like, yeah. It was so cold. So
well,
it's one
I
or the
wore
other.
A dress that was had like panels of just skin, and like I maybe
grafted from somebody else.
But maybe it was, you know, somebody shafting me. But she said, "Wow, you really dress the occasion. Like you dress for the weather," which frankly I thought was sort of a compliment because I saw all these actresses just like passing out from the heat.
People should pass out on those carpets.
Yeah, absolutely.
That's what I do.
Two people passed out of the last Emmys on the carpet.
I mean, do you get a chance to dress for the carpet though? I mean, aren't they making these dresses like months in advance? And you know,
these actresses are picking, they're pulling them at the 11th hour.
Oh, are they?
They are. No,
they come down to four choices and it's red lights, and then they expect all these alterations and everything. Mm. Renee, you're gonna take us through your best and worst dress, and we're all gonna comment because
let's do some critiquing. Okay. How did you set these up?
Like, in the order you sent me.
Oh, okay.
From your iPhone. By the way, your phone number is in this. No, I'm just
kidding. Okay, that's all right. That's
your Grindr profile is here too. All right, Spreaker. So your first best dress. Oh, P.S. Kurt, since he's straight, has no idea who the actresses' names are.
Okay.
I've learned this from the recaps. I say, play Nicole Kidman, and he'll, like, Liza Minnelli will
pop up.
Pop up, yeah. Okay.
It's always Liza, too.
Oh, okay.
So, oh, no. This is actually mine. You didn't include this.
Okay, yeah, that one's Louise Dreyfus.
Yeah. What order? Start from the first dress, sweetie. There we go.
Okay, so this is Blake Lively.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm.
Okay. And she's in the an Atelier Versace.
Yeah.
Which is, it's got the cowl neck collar. This is a black velvet gown, showcased her voluptuous curves.
Yeah.
This look is very classic old Hollywood.
It looks very classic.
Yeah. It's at its finest, I think. It's very retro. It's very chic.
I expected Blake to be a little bit more playful, though.
But you know what? I like about this
it's definitely conservative for her.
Very
I think.
Conservative.
Very conservative.
Yeah, but then
what did you did you like the sort of kangaroo pockets though? Like the
yes,
yeah,
I'm say
bored.
That.
Exactly. Bored.
Her dress is boring.
All right, it's too
You're
boring.
Blake
okay.
Lively.
But look at that great train that she's got. It's black velvet. I don't know. Black velvet's always chic. It goes everywhere. I mean, it's a good look.
The two of them, like the two of them walking down the carpet together, they looked old Hollywood. They looked fantastic.
I mean,
together.
They looked old more than Hollywood.
Well, there you go. Emphasis on the old bed.
But I appreciate.
But look
that.
At that plunging neckline. He's got that nice big.
It was the year of the boob.
And she actually has.
It was the year of the boob.
Because you texted me, and here's the thing: so many flat-chested women were wearing this, like. Girl, get some falsies or something.
Okay, well, you guys all live here, all right? And I'm hoping to live here at some point.
Oh, you don't live here?
You can room with me.
Wow, where do you live?
You guys, I'm in Atlanta.
Oh,
that's not a fake story.
Yeah. And, okay, I didn't catch that. Okay, I just thought I love that you're here, though. This is great. Yeah.
So, she's so adorable.
But I have to say,
oh,
like,
you got to move here.
What's
yeah.
the deal with, like, these what's plunging the necklines
with
and
no breasts,
with no boobs.
Okay, but here's
I don't
the thing.
Get it. We don't all have boobs, and
no. It's not about it's, do you have boobs? Or don't
yeah, but
you
let me tell you something. If you put Pamela Anderson in that, she would look like a hooker. Okay, look like a prostitute. You can't put a girl with huge, big ass boobs and super
though.
Something low and plunging.
Okay, but
no, but you're wearing something that's appropriate for you.
Yeah, but there's got to be a fine line between like hooker look and now I look like a 12-year-old boy. There's got to be a fine line.
I even have that joke written down. Yeah, that's right. It's like,
well,
I
wrote that joke for you, but I just stole it. Sorry.
But it's like, did they put the dress on backwards?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sometimes we do.
They did that on the comeback.
That was the joke with Jay.
We're just all stealing your jokes.
I still don't know where. There's no
Patrick,
tag in this dress.
Okay, so if it. But here's the thing. Like, if it's a real high fashion look, you look at all the couture fashion that comes out of Paris and Milan. You've got. The models do not have these big implant boobs.
That's,
this is an LA
I
look. Okay,
that,
you go to
but.
New York, you don't have that. You come to LA, it's all about TNA. It's the booby girl on the beach. It's not a high fashion look. It's okay, a Hollywood look.
But let's bring it
okay?
to.
Okay. No, I'm just yeah, letting you know, like, what about letting you know what real high fashion is, and that's what you're going to see on the runways. You're going to see these small little boobs, and you're going to see low plunging necklines because real fashion models they have like A B cup boobs. They're not.
They're not fashion models.
Boobs.
They're actresses.
Okay, but
and here's the thing: you went to the Netflix Awards, and the women you were with were dressed so well that fit their curves.
Yeah.
We know Lisa Rinna has. But oh, she wasn't showing everything. She
right,
was.
Because if you put Lisa Rinna in one of those super low plunging things, she could do a version of that. But it's all about the placement. It really it is. Because if you show too much of the boob, you cross the line from going from tasteful to you go from Park Avenue to Playboy magazine is what
that,
you do.
But don't show off something that you don't have. Why did everybody stop talking?
I kind of agree with you. I think it's an odd. I understand.
Fit in your body.
You
if you have no chest.
Wanna,
well, no.
Like Natalie Portman has no chest.
Right.
Well, right now she does because she's about to pop.
Well, we're going to talk about that outfit too.
The Captain Kirk?
I just assume not people, women popping. Like, I mean.
I like women's boobs. I deal with them all day long, so I'm constantly seeing. I'm feeling them. I'm checking them out.
If you have them, flaunt them.
Yeah, but it's like. But on the flip side, though, if you have some big, huge udders and you're doing some big low
udders,
yeah, they are. Because some of them, then you look. I'm telling you guys, you because then everybody, all they're going to talk about is you see how big our boobs are. You know?
No, I understand what you're saying.
It's all about refinement.
It's
all about sophistication. It's about elegance.
I just think that you can. There's a way to split the difference.
Right,
yes,
absolutely.
Between, like,
and it's that fine line. Yeah. So it's like, if a girl has nice handfuls and she can do low cut, but if they're super huge,
yes.
I'm telling you, you're going
to. But I'm not asking for that. I'm just asking for people to fit their body. Let's go to the next
okay.
All right.
Best
dress.
So we did Blake. Okay, so then the next one I have is
this really
Emma Stone.
Me.
Oh, wait, who do we have up there? Wait a minute. Oh, wait. Oh, we have Nicole Kidman. You have Nicole Kidman up there. Okay, yep. we can go back to her. Okay.
Oh, I thought it was Emma Stone. It's not. Okay.
Yeah.
That's Nicole.
Oh.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, okay.
I actually just talked about this outfit tonight.
Okay. So you talked, yes, we did. We briefly talked about it. Okay, so it's Alexander McQueen. I like it. It's a real.
Love Alexander McQueen, by the way.
Oh, yeah, absolutely, yeah. This is a very runway look. It's very high fashion. I liked it. I thought it was great. I thought, I liked the fact, well, Nicole, she's 5'10". She can carry off all kinds of things.
Yes.
So you tell me what
she
you
did. She towered over.
What? You want to take a look at that?
You were there, sweetie.
No, I know, but
the whole thing was a blackout.
Yeah, exactly. That was just because of the drinking.
Yep.
No, the sleeves were what bothered me.
Okay, yeah. That's okay. Exactly what I was saying.
That's what everybody says.
If the sleeves were gone, that dress would have been beautiful.
Yeah, yeah.
But
it
here's
fits
the thing.
Her amazingly.
It's a little Disney, the little puff thing going on there. I know, it's a little
it's just
different.
Hideous. She's like Corpse Bride at a disco.
But it's
like,
side puffs, too. Yeah. It's, I mean, it's very...
It just didn't fit.
It's like 80s palm.
But you know what? The color also bothered me. It would not have bothered me if I just saw this picture,
uh-huh.
But her behavior on the red carpet, she was like so like sad and like lonely. Like
really, when
told,
I saw her, she could. They were so happy. Like and I
really?
Saw them at the end of the carpet, so I would have thought that's when they would be so sad. But they might have been that
out.
Way earlier.
Because
but.
Like with Ryan Seacrest, she's like, "Oh, well, we should hang out. Can I come to your house?" It was like, "You're Nicole Kidman. You don't need to beg Ryan Seacrest to like you know hang out."
Well, I mean, what was the giggling between her and Reese Witherspoon when they were presenting the award? What was that about? Is that?
I think it was manufactured. I really do.
Wait, which one did they present?
I think they're just nervous, maybe. Huh?
Was that what it was?
Was it best actor?
Because
well,
they have the
like,
new show and they need to prove to everybody that
right.
they're a great mix. Because people say Nicole Kidman and Reese Witherspoon. How does that even legally
Laura Dern.
Australian?
Are they meaning
Laura
make
Dern
the same
and
frame.
Then Shailene Woodley? Like it's a very weird.
But I'll say.
I'm over Shailene Woodley.
I'll say Reese. I got to interview Reese and she was telling me that. The minute that she decided that that was what she wanted to do, because she produced that, her production company put that together, the minute
Which
she decided
awesome.
to option that book and put it together, she called Nicole Kidman and was like, I want you to be a part of this. And I guess I'm assuming that the author is either Australian or lives in Australia. And she says, Nicole was like, I'm in, I'm going to go visit the author and tell him we're doing this, like all that kind of stuff. And she like got involved right away. So they really have been really close for a long time now working on that.
And I'll be honest, HBO has been doing some really good stuff. Westworld, amazing. Mm. You have to be kidding me.
Mm.
Why?
I thought the acting was really well done. I just thought that the right, you could tell the moment that they stopped, took a year off to re-put it to put it all back together and then come back and finish the second half.
We have never not gotten along.
I know, but I'm just telling you, it wasn't. I loved the acting. I thought the story was interesting, but they did. I mean, that's just what happened. They took almost a year off to retool the whole show because it wasn't working, and you can tell halfway through the season that that's what happened. That's all I'm saying.
You guys don't, okay?
Not, not in front of the kids. Okay,
this now. Is our first
this
fight.
This is too much.
No, but HO is putting, like, this series is coming out. The Young Pope with Jude Law is coming out. Divorce, I thought, was a great show.
Yeah, I love Divorce. Yeah. There
and
we go.
Glad
we're back
it was
to,
a
we're back
half
to.
Hour, by the way. I'm glad it couldn't have been an hour at all. Okay, yeah. So the next look.
So. Okay, so the next one. So we're on with Natalie Portman. So you thought this was very Star Trek, huh? Is that what you thought?
She literally has the Star Trek braid on her sleeve.
So see, I gave this.
And it's
this,
Prada,
this,
right?
Yeah, this is Prada. This is a mustard yellow gold, a four-ply crepe silk. It's,
please tell me that's not Captain Kirk.
Well, I thought it was very. I thought she was channeling very. It's very Jacqueline Kennedy.
I
was
I
very
knew that's
chic.
What she was
that's
doing.
That's what everybody
yeah.
said.
She was doing yeah, and I thought it was.
And I don't
I
think
thought,
you should dress up like your character.
But I also
it's
say
not Halloween
in person. Well, in person, I thought it looked fantastic. Then I saw a photo, and I thought that the color didn't.
But it was also
the color didn't translate
her bouffant.
The color
mustard's pretty tough to wear, I think, for anybody.
Yeah. But I'm right. saying in person, yeah. I would thought she's glowing, she looks fantastic, yeah. and then I saw pictures, and I was like, oh, it's one of those things. It's like when you take a picture of a sunset, and you're like, oh, this
well,
is
but
crap.
Then also when okay, this is an Empire waist, so it's like when you're pregnant or you have a belly, this is a great silhouette to wear, and the lines are good.
I
for
get
it.
All yeah. of that. Nobody would have thought like this literally looks like a Star Trek. And then the other problem I had were her eyebrows.
Oh, I didn't check out.
They were
the
like
eyebrows.
Two caterpillars fighting
I just,
her.
I
like,
couldn't
space.
Get past the color. I have to be honest. Like the mustard color was just.
Grey Poupon's
a lot.
Hard to wear, you know, right? Or is
Whatever,
it? You think it's French?
Grey Poupon? Do we still have Grey Poupon?
Right? Oh, I still get it. Yeah.
But I think the problem with it though is too is because it looks different on the page than it looks different at the screen we're looking at. And it looks different in person. Every time it looks like a different color.
But a stylist and Renee, speak to this. A stylist should know how it appears on camera.
Well, that's the tricky part because right now we're doing stuff for Lily Tomlin. We're making clothes for her.
She must be really tough because she's a little bit more handsome in her approach. No. I'm not being rude, but you know, she's Violet in 9 to 5. That's her style. She's like B. Arthur. She's the new B. Arthur.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Right?
She's
Lily Tomlin.
Let me tell you, she's
Lily Tomlin. You know, but in her style.
She is awesome, I got to tell you. Oh, yeah. She's like, she's so much fun to work with. But we just had this problem yesterday because when I show the style, her stylist was contacted us because we're designing the gown for her for the SAG Award. She's getting a Lifetime Achievement Award.
She's wearing a gown.
She's wearing a gown. Yeah, well, she's wearing a long skirt with a scoop neck fitted top. So, but it's an evening look, and I can't give away too much because I want to blow it for her. Anyway.
But this excites me. Yeah. Now we're all gonna be watching.
But here's the thing, like her stylist said, oh, you know, photograph the fabric swatches so I can see what they look like. Okay, well the fabric in person when you look at it and then I take a photograph of it, it's a totally different color. So then I send it to you and then you look at these swatches over your phone and you're like, oh, I like that, or you know, like it could be it's misinterpreted basically.
And also different lighting. If it's daytime, if it's nighttime.
If you're under fluorescent,
if it's yellow
lighting,
light,
if
you're
outside,
sweating,
if
you're bloating, it's
tough because you don't know what elements you're going to be under, right? When you're on the red carpet,
and a flash versus no flash.
Men have it so easy. But see? I was.
Oh, I've literally worn the same exact suit to every award show I've covered for People, and that's been 6 years now. Oh, thank you. And every
six
time,
years.
And every
all
time,
right.
literally right? two different people it's on the carpet so go, "Oh my God, is this new? I love this one." I'm like, "Nope, it's literally the exact same one."
I wore
one.
This on the radio tonight, and now I'll never be able to wear it again.
Really? Mm.
But I love it. It looks like you grafted it from other people.
Well, you know, it's not yoga pants.
Your yoga pant posts, though, because your fans are creepy. They love you in yoga pants. Renee, we saw a lot of, and Patrick, you saw this. We saw so many double-breasted tuxedos, which I love double breasts because it's 1940s. You cannot be chubby and wear a double breast. That's why I love
well,
it.
Well, you also can't be short and wear a double breast either. You know, it's kind of
tough.
But
we saw all that. Who decides?
Well, some of those men that were wearing those double breasts could wear anything. And it's
this
fine.
True.
So
true.
But like, who decides? Like, oh, it. Because
this year it's double breasted.
Exactly. Because it came out of nowhere.
It was the year of the breasts.
It was.
Female or male.
Female or male.
But the men had more breasts than the females.
Yes.
It's all about a killer rack, right? Yeah.
Rack at Nordstrom's rack. okay, so what is your next?
So the next one, let's see. Who we're up to now? We're up with, Reese Witherspoon. Okay, so that was one of my favorites. I thought it was great. I know that this is very in vain of what We actually design a lot of this type of thing. This is Versace. Very classic Hollywood. It's butter yellow, four-ply grape silk. It's great.
But she loves yellow, too. Yeah. She loves wearing yellow.
It shows a little leg. I like the neckline's very interesting. I like the drape across each, breast there. And I don't know. I thought you find it just too boring? Nothing? Eh.
I thought it was predictable. Yeah. It's perfect for it. When you go to a wedding, you wear something and you, oh, great. That's great. It's nothing spectacular, but
I don't find her really that spectacular anyway.
Yeah. We don't expect that from her. Okay. Yeah.
I mean, I like her as an actress, but she's not like somebody that I'm like looking through the pages of Vogue like, oh,
she's someone exactly. I want to party with her though.
Right.
Girl knows how to drink.
I guarantee you. She's from the South. She's
those Southern
fun.
Girls, they know how to drink,
I guarantee
right?
You. But I don't
she's
know
vegan.
Her.
That's a
she's
no.
Oh,
fun.
Really? Yep. That means they can get drunk really fast, though. That could be fun, right?
No, because then you deal sloppy. With these straight girls at the Abbey that you have to carry out and have to, no.
Well, that's a whole other, that's another show.
I'm right here.
No, girl, you can put it down.
Oh, okay.
We have sent alcohol sponsors home.
So Emma Stone, we're on Emma Stone now?
Now I actually love this.
I thought this was gorgeous. I thought it was beautiful. This blush pink. It's Valentino Couture with his chiffon gown with the silver stars scattered throughout
it. It reminded me of Debbie Reynolds, honestly.
Did it? Really?
I loved her speech when she won. Like, I just thought she was fantastic. I'm a huge fan.
That movie, it was my life.
La La Land?
Oh, my God. Like, literally.
People either love that movie or hate the movie.
I never dated Ryan Gosling, and that's a regret. But other than that, literally every
why are we all gaga
about
Ryan
that.
Gosling? You know one of his eyes goes off to
He's
the side.
Gorgeous.
That's okay as long as one of them is looking at me.
Okay, I'm more of a Ryan Reynolds. I'm just going to say it.
I mean, both.
But they're just so ordinary.
No, but I'm talking about the
I
movie.
Like Diego Luna.
Oh, I do too.
Yeah.
Although, I will say...
He's got kind of like a dirty...
In person...
If somebody has a lazy eye or a fake leg, I'm all about it.
In person? Because I've never been about him. I like got to meet him on the carpet briefly, and he
Diego?
Was striking and just like looked fantastic.
You look like Diego.
And then... Oh, well, thank you. At least it's in person.
None of
the Mexicans
look alike.
Thank you. Thank you. PSA moment. No, but then I saw him like literally on camera. I see him literally all the time tonight. On screen later that evening, and he looked so old, so much older. He looked so young in person and like vibrant. And then I looked on there, and he looked just tired.
That's awful, right? Mm-hmm. You're not like photogenic or something. That'd be horrible. Right?
Well, he's clearly doing just fine.
Yeah, he's
but let's be honest. Like the lighting and the editing and everything for the show was shit. Was shit.
Was it shitty? Yeah.
Well, the teleprompter.
But like the DJ on stage, it didn't.
Oh,
seem
I actually
like
loved. I actually loved Questlove and the music. I thought it was cool. So, it freshened it up
but
a little
if
bit.
We talk about Hollywood. Hollywood comes with a certain glamour. You need a live orchestra. Anyway, we're gonna get to that. Okay. I'm really concerned with your love for this.
Yeah. Okay.
You just don't like this color. You just don't like.
Yeah. You don't like yellow, do
What's
you?
With
Let me
yellow?
Tell you,
it's
Ryan Seacrest. Ryan Seacrest literally asked Viola Davis, "What color is your dress?" He literally asked that.
What's wrong with him? Why would he ask that?
He's colorblind, maybe.
Well, this
don't
is like.
Judge.
Oh, is he really colorblind?
No, I don't know. Oh. I'm just saying, could be.
But he literally asked her.
So somebody like so a woman like Viola Davis that they've got that dark skin tone.
Yep.
So the jewel tones actually was, so she could do hot red, she could do a vibrant
like
purple,
a
magenta,
this?
Or yeah, royal blue, any of those jewel tone colors, but you don't like the bright yellow.
And let's be honest, she knew she was gonna win, so she knew that this outfit was
I thought she looked good.
I thought
it looked
gorgeous.
Great, yeah.
I mean,
this was designed by Michael Kors, but
he gave
and
up
do you think because wait, did she would she did you in supporting or lead?
I think he's kind of overrated anyway. So yeah,
a few years ago.
That's it. It's like, I wore Calvin Klein socks. Nobody cares.
I don't think it because she's going for supporting in at the Oscars. Mm-hmm.
Did you guys see Fences?
Yeah,
let's mix in because I love that we're taking time up, but let's mix it in. I saw Fences.
Mm-hmm.
No good.
No. Who saw Fences?
Yeah, I did. I have a real problem with it.
I do too. So let's talk about the film.
I didn't see the film, but I have seen the play several
times.
Well,
then you've seen the film. There's
yeah,
no
it's basically,
need.
Yeah.
Like it's just unnecessary. The fact that I'm sorry, I'll totally take a role from you, Denzel Washington, if you want to offer. But you should not be.
He was so full of himself throughout
well,
the whole film.
Well, he shouldn't get an Oscar for it. He already won the Tony. Like, and there's nothing.
She did too, right?
No, she didn't play his wife in that. Yeah,
but
the point is, I mean, I feel like film is a different medium, and so it should do things that it can't do on stage. And there's nothing about this movie that we didn't already see on
Broadway.
It's
a good film.
Yeah.
What I'm sick and tired of is all these good films. A film should be good. Why are we honoring good films?
But they're not. But that's because they're the best ones out there right now.
No, well, I mean, the acting was incredible, but it wasn't any different than what we've seen on stage.
The acting was okay. I don't think Denzel did a great job. He was so full of himself, and I don't think you should direct yourself. That's what I think.
I agree with that. I think in a
role of that size, you need to get out of your way, and you need to have somebody else's eyes, you know, telling you, giving you notes and stuff.
It's
like that.
It's kind of like the Barbara Streisand thing, right? Yeah, doesn't herself too?
Yeah, she did.
Or Mel Gibson.
I think when they get that big, they just think they can do it everything. Yeah. They can do it all. Produce it, direct it, act it.
Yeah. Great.
But it's not, then co-direct. You can direct all the other scenes that you're not in.
Yep.
The one film project I worked on, that was the one thing. We had two directors, and if we always directed if the other one was in it, and the one episode that we were in scenes together, we brought in another director because we were like, that's, no, like, you can't have that. You just need other voices. Yeah. You need those creative voices in there.
You need an outside eye. Yeah.
But it's also a thing.
You need that third eye, right? Mm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. See? Yeah.
I can see Viola in other roles. When I see Denzel, all I see is Denzel.
Well, my favorite headline that I read about of a review of Fences was Viola Davis out Denzel's Denzel Washington.
But
she out-charmed him. She outdid everything that he normally is loved for.
But honestly, I really feel like in the play, the role that Viola Davis plays is meant to do that. I mean, she has some amazing monologues that it's like you're going. There's no way you're not going to steal the show. And when you're her, you're definitely going to steal the show. Like, it's just...
I just want to know if she cries like that in Real Person. Because every time she cries, she's got, like, snot. And I'm just like, normal people would, like, wipe that away. And she's just like, I'm just going to let it hang. And it's like, no, but, like...
She knows it's going to be filmed.
But, like, a real person would wipe... Like, a real moment, you would be like, oh, I look...
No.
I thought this was a documentary.
But with Denzel, it even goes to his personality. Every time they cut to him at the Golden Globes, he was like this.
Yeah. I see him at the Four Seasons Hotel. He always goes there on Sundays.
To be honest,
brunch,
that was the face you were making watching the show at home. So.
Yeah, but if I was there and had the honor, you'd bring it up. Denzel really has a bloated idea of himself.
I'm sure.
He's not a happy person. I see him at the Four Seasons Hotel, and they have put this amazing brunch on Sundays, and he's always got that grumpy face. And how can you not enjoy that brunch over there? It's amazing.
Like you've eaten the brunch.
I do. I eat the brunch. Yeah.
And then he throws it off.
I just go to the bathroom and throw it up.
The biscuits that he pours gravy on.
Right. Yeah. All right. So let's look at
another
outfit.
And then he does a three-day juice cleanse, and it's all
and we all hear about
it. With cayenne pepper. Yeah, right.
Everybody. I'm vegan now. I'm blah, blah, blah. Okay.
Okay, so the next one, Amy Adams. I thought she dazzled us on the red carpet in the Tom Ford.
She dazzled
Jet
you?
Black. Yeah.
Dazzled you? You're the same person that thinks, Manchester by the Sea was the best film. No.
I thought this was such a great look, but I mean, Tom Ford can't do anything. He can't do wrong, you know?
Can he not do wrong because you think he should not do wrong or from actual...
No, I think it's I respect his aesthetic, and I think he's got a great sense of style and design. But I mean, look what he did for Gucci, turned that whole thing around, and that's why Gucci's so great today. But
what did he do for her body? It looks like she forgot the straps, and it looks like the Matrix at Studio 54.
I like the neckline because it's contemporary. I think it looks really modern and it's kind of cool. It's got an edge to it.
Well, I will just say Alexander has something against Tom Ford's opinion because Alexander threw some shade at me for my hair. He was like, you need some product in your hair. And literally earlier that day, Tom Ford would go, I love your hair. So clearly you just don't have the same aesthetic.
Honey,
he wasn't talking about
your hair. Let's just be honest.
I was seated behind a giant table. All you could see was from here.
Which hair was he referring to?
Yeah, exactly.
But I hear he's very pretentious. So
did
he
give you some product?
Yeah.
Well, so he won't
take photos in the daylight any longer, and then he'll only be photographed with a suit on,
but
with a white
shirt.
But
this is why this upsets me. When I interview like Tippi Hedren, who was in this horrible lighting and whatever, and they're like, okay, let's do this. Mm-hmm. This is what upsets me.
I mean, look at
I
came in this horrible lighting. I'm still doing it. See, right? Come on.
You're two steps away from Tom Ford's movie.
just giving you a hard time.
I really don't like it. And here's the thing. It didn't fit Amy Adams' hair in my eyes. And she always looks like she has watery eyes, by the way.
I think her hair could have been better because I've seen her hair better.
You know what I'm talking about.
Maybe she's sad.
Maybe it's Maybelline.
Maybe she was just talking.
Got some Maybelline
right?
in the eye. Yeah. That's what happened.
I feel like Kate Kneeland and I are going to go to like a British pub and just get wasted.
I have to say something.
Uh-oh. Yes. Oh, okay. Please do. Yeah. Everybody, say TMZ. It. This is when say we start recording.
Why
for TMZ.
Is it an actress's job to necessarily be beautiful on the red carpet? I mean, why? Why?
Because. It's
I mean, isn't the whole job to take us on a journey and to, you know, make us feel and portray another role in another place, take us to another
Honey,
time?
This coming from you, when you knock out every red carpet and you do it.
But listen, I'm imagining.
So why do you do it then?
I'm imagining if you guys were all sitting around talking about me. Oh my God, can you believe this?
But you look amazing.
But Alexander does.
Skin graft.
When you're not
on.
Here, that's all you can talk about.
No,
I don't know. I guess part of me just like I feel bad for her. Like I'm looking at her right now, and I'm like, oh.
But that's
God.
The job. That's the job.
I guess, but like I don't know. We don't look at plumbers and go like, oh my God, his butt crack.
Well, we all do look at
actually,
those,
we
don't
do
we?
Do that,
right?
Don't
yeah.
we?
Yeah. Right? Yeah.
We do.
No, I don't know.
You call
it
out
know.
When you see
it. I
like the Amy Adams dress. I thought she's...
I do too.
It was okay. And I'm sick and tired of Hollywood being okay. Fences was okay. Manchester by the Sea was okay.
Not even.
Well, I love... I actually...
You agree with me.
Yeah.
Actually, Manchester by the Sea minus.
Actually tweeted that night because everyone... Twice on the show, somebody said, like, this has been a great year for female roles. This has been a great year for movies. And I was like, for once, I'd love for somebody to just go up there like, it was a crap year for movies,
so
but these are the best of what we got.
Where is that
Yeah,
voice?
I like that. That'd be great. Yeah, right?
Yeah.
This year really sucked, right?
Yeah.
So but I think we found two or three that were decent. What do you think, right?
Yeah.
But it wasn't even really that great of a year for female roles in movies. I mean,
it was a great year for Amy Adams in female roles.
Watery Eye, sponsored by Visine. So let's actually go around. What was your favorite film of 2016?
Oh, that's putting me on the spot.
People Magazine.
Yeah.
With your Tom Ford
I actually really, really liked Arrival. And I know that was another one that people either loved or liked. I loved, liked La La Land.
I love La La Land.
So that's...
I loved the first... Okay, I loved the first 30 minutes and I loved the last 30 minutes. The middle 30 minutes, I could have used something different.
I love that you're being honest about
this. It dragged a little bit.
I
did
really
like
find
it, though.
It's funny because
yeah.
Naomi... If I need to dish with somebody, it's you, because you're like, I hated it.
Oh, yeah.
And so you would love La La Land.
Oh, my God. I mean, I just, like I said, I related to every second. I have been a barista. I have done one-woman shows. I have had more people in on stage than there were in the audience. I have not dated Ryan Gosling. But, I mean, you know.
You guys, one of his eyes goes to the side. Why can't we talk about that?
I have dated guys like that, too. The point is, yeah, I part of me was like, who has been spying on my life and then wrote it and then produced
no,
it?
No, I mean, I agree. My thing is, it was so visually inventive. It was so creative in the visuals and the music was so fun. The storyline itself to me was something that we've seen a lot. So I would have just loved some sort of twist on that, some sort of difference.
I have not seen all those dancers on the 405.
You know what I'm saying? The musical numbers, the dancing, the music, that all was fantastic.
La La Land made history as the top nominated film.
Well, good.
Did it really?
It deserves it. I will say, I think the best acting of the year was in Moonlight.
Oh, love Moonlight too.
Hands down, yeah.
Rene, what was your top film for 2016?
Dirty Grandpa. Anything with Zac Efron in it, I like. So, yeah, it was good. I like that.
Be serious.
No, I did like La La Land. I did like Dirty Grandpa because I thought De Niro was kind of funny in that because it was so not something that the ending was kind of weak, but I did enjoy it.
I love
you
know? Critiquing Dirty Grandpa. I'm
still talking about it.
I love it.
What about Bad Santa?
Yeah.
Really?
I will say I really liked Allied.
You can only pick one.
Allied.
What'd you say? I really liked Allied.
I want to see Allied.
Oh,
I love
I really
there
liked
was zero chemistry.
Oh, I disagree. I was like when they were in the car together, I was
wait
like
wait a minute.
Woo!
Why did everybody cheer for Brad Pitt so much when all he did was
that was a great PR move.
Is that awesome. Against Angelina?
I don't think it's against
Angelina.
I think
it's just showing support for him, given all the stuff, you know, just all the
what'd
craziness around it. He walked out on stage. And
he was a surprise. He was a surprise performer.
He was a surprise. Nobody knew that he was going to be there. So they, you know,
is he a good actor? Do we think he's a good actor? I say no. Sorry.
No. Sometimes.
I think sometimes, yeah. I think he can.
He has to be directed then.
I heard he can't be interviewed. You ever notice that? He's never in an interview because he can't speak.
I actually watched his Inside the Actor Studio recently, and he actually was really good on that.
Yeah. Oh wow!
I'm chuckling that he has Inside the Actor Studio. Yeah. This is what we're doing now, really?
I mean, think about it though.
But James Lapine is like, I mean, he's at this point,
he's literally like FaceTiming in.
That's true. I'm not saying that being on Inside the Actor Studio means that you're a great
actor.
Should
I be the new Inside the Actor Studio?
Yes,
you don't have enough index cards.
Yes, you should.
They're like up to here.
You were terrible in this film. What do you think about that, Kate? What was your top film of 2016?
You had time to prepare. He dropped that on me.
No, I know. But I'm a mom of a 2.5-year-old, so...
I really liked Moana.
Have you not seen all the movies?
Oh, my God. Bad Moms. Moana didn't Bad even... Moms was good, too. Did you see Bad Moms? Oh, that was so good.
She's in The Founder, and Oscar...
That's 2017.
Film. Right, so...
I didn't...
You guys, she's so cute.
Why am I cute? I mean, thank you.
Because you're from Atlanta.
And I've got that doe-eyed you guys.
We just never see it anymore. So.
Oh, okay.
So how do you do auditions when you're in Atlanta? Do you like fly out here all the time?
Everything shoots in Atlanta now.
Oh, really?
There's a lot happening.
You guys, we're getting away from.
I want you to be on Walking Dead.
I want to be on Walking Dead. That would be fantastic. Hello, out there, Walking Dead people.
Make it happen. Right?
Vote for me.
Yeah.
I was joking with her. Since you're in Atlanta, you should be on every Tyler Perry project.
Yeah.
Since Heather Locklear is doing it. Oh, God. Talk about Walking Dead.
Really?
Oh, thank you.
What about The Real Housewives of Atlanta? You could do that maybe, right?
Yeah.
She wouldn't put up with that.
You'd be the white chick on there.
Yes. Yeah. I'd be the white chick.
I thought Kim was the white.
Oh, she's not on it anymore.
Which one is that? The one tardy for the party? Whatever?
Yeah, that is tardy for the party.
I love that.
That hairstyle. That hairstyle's been good to her, huh? She's had that for a long time.
Well, she bought it.
So yeah, literally, she just puts it on.
Yeah.
What's your film?
Okay, I'm sorry to say that I have not seen all of the nominated films, I'm gonna say only because it's the one that I've seen is Manchester by the Sea.
Ugh.
Okay.
Are you kidding right now, Kate?
No, I'm not. Here's the thing. Like,
she's from Atlanta.
No, it's not because I'm from
she's
Atlanta.
She's
curds. Let's stop hating on the South.
Just hold on a second, you guys.
she's so adorable. When you win your Oscar next year, you have to say thank you, Alexander.
I absolutely will. Yeah. Are you kidding? So I hope you guys will have me back, even though I'm from Atlanta, because I am planning on moving here. So you have to have me back.
Know,
we also do Skype, though.
I'm for you. I want to hear your defense of Manchester by the Sea.
It's Manchester by the Sea minus.
Not just.
If you need a real estate agent, let me know. I know. Yeah.
And that's being generous.
Yeah. It's an
Oh, I don't think it was that. I didn't love it, but that was mainly because it just...
The reason I have to say it is because it's the one I've seen, you guys.
Oh, so...
That's fair.
But I would say
Rogue
did
One.
You not,
I would
did,
vote for Rogue what about One. It,
did, I, you know what? I did see Rogue One. And
Rogue One
I,
sucked.
I loved Rogue
Why
One.
Did you say Rogue One? I loved it. Okay,
you guys, I'm
talk
the
to
biggest
me.
Sci-fi nerd in the world.
Listen,
couldn't do it.
I can rival you on sci-fi nerdery.
No, I don't think you can. I've had Walter Koenig on the show.
Okay.
Oh, puff puff, yeah.
I have Star Trek.
I was there for that one.
Oh yeah, remember when the dog was running around? We had a dog running around, and he was like, "Can we shut the fuck up?" It was awful. Anyway.
Okay, so why didn't you like Rogue One? What's your issues?
I thought the acting was really bad. I thought the story done there. I'm sick of talking to the Death Star. And when Darth Vader came out, he didn't look like Darth Vader.
He didn't look like Darth Vader. That did bother
the
me.
The helmet was, because the original and Darth Vader, the helmet is up. I pay attention to every detail.
Maybe he had there. A makeover in like the 30 minutes in between that movie and
yeah, maybe,
the new
maybe, maybe it's a cosmetic surgeon,
say,
right?
I also have to say the freakiest part of Rogue One for me was the general...
He looks so real.
But
he did not.
He
in
didn't.
The first,
he looked like Polar Express to me. I was Polar Express is all of a sudden in the movie, and I was like,
girl,
"What's
happening? How long are you here for?" No, honestly,
I'm here for a week, and then I'm planning on coming back. So.
Can Tad like?
Yeah, sure.
We're going to do happy hour. We're going to dish.
Happy hour.
So, but wait, I want to hear why you guys hated Manchester by the Sea.
Yeah, I would like to know. I mean, I will say this. I think it's one of those movies that you watch, and while you're watching it, you know this is going to be nominated for an Academy Award.
I hate that. Exactly.
I think that's one of those. It's like last year with the movie Carol. I felt the same thing. I was like, okay,
Carol
it's beautiful.
Carol was a snore fest.
It's beautiful to look at, but it's obvious that I'm supposed to be.
But you didn't love that scene between Michelle Williams and Casey Affleck when they're in this with the stroller.
I will be honest with you.
That scene to me is one of the best acted scenes.
She knew this is my scene and she emoted and whatever. It didn't fit the rest of the film. The film was boring. Mm-hmm. The film is supposed to be a slice of life. Mm. All of us have had slices of life. Mm-hmm. And we're just nominating films because they're serious.
I will agree with you. The thing is that the movie is sad, and it just stays sad, and it gets sadder.
Yeah, sadder and sadder and sadder.
It was kind of like him on stage. When he presented, he just seemed like a flat tire.
Why are we honoring these films?
But if you're going to say is the women,
well, right, we should be honoring the founders. Thank you, but.
Anti-man.
But I want to say that the problem when they say slice of life film is it's fine if there's sad moments, but even in the sadness, there are always these moments of levity that really do happen.
I get it, and I love that.
Comedy, but they didn't have any of that. That's my point. They missed out on that.
He had like little jokes. The kid was like, whatever. But it's not.
I thought the kid was the best part.
He's fantastic.
He was fantastic.
And he's getting a lot of buzz for like breakout.
I think that he should definitely be seen more.
I just don't think we should honor films just because they're serious.
I agree with that, but
I do think that Manchester was one of the better films of the year.
Are you kidding?
Okay, just I remember that's the one I've seen out of all of them. So,
I'm really confused. What are your top two films?
Oh well, I mean, I guess I listed. I guess.
Are you gonna say the Dirty Grandpa?
Yeah, Dirty Grandpa and Bad Moms. I'm stealing yours.
See, they are good, right?
But I mean,
I'll tell you what.
I will say La La Land because it was something new and exciting. Like even though I had issues with it, it still is one of my favorites. I think Rogue One I loved.
What? I really liked
Moonlight.
It.
Best acting of the.
But okay, Moonlight for me was another one like Manchester by the Sea where I was just like everything was. I thought the acting was fantastic. I thought the story telling was inventive. I loved all of that. But it just wasn't a movie I walked out and was like, I'm so excited I saw that.
No, I wasn't excited. I cried my eyes out. I stuck my head in the oven. I
and I'll be honest, for something to move Naomi because she'll tell Marley Matlin to. Listen up.
Wait, who?
you're like, listen up, Buttercup.
No,
huh?
I mean, yeah. I'm serious.
You're like, I can't hear you.
No, but I didn't see Moonlight. I'll be honest.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, I haven't seen it yet.
But yeah, for it to be a favorite, I guess for me to call something a favorite of mine, it's something that I want to go back and revisit. Yeah. There's some movies that are homework in the sense that you're like, this is a work of art. I'm glad I saw it, but I don't necessarily want to go see it again.
Patrick, what was like your top film of all time?
Of all time?
Wow. First Wives Club.
Oh, my God. I feel like we're about to have like radio silence. Like
I could probably
Borat.
To me, your favorite movie should be something that you want to watch at any moment. So which means to me a comedy.
Mine is Star Trek 3 and The Women.
So there you go. Don't judge my First Wives Club. If it wasn't that, it would be Drop Dead Gorgeous or Noises Off.
If wasn't that, it'd be Bruno.
Mine would be Auntie
Renee. Take
someone's searching for a Sasha Baron Cohen phone call.
All right, let's get back to clothes.
Let's get back to the
you guys. Literally, the whole show now. We're not even covering the actual show.
Let's get back to the real
issue. I thought this was over a half hour ago.
Are we not going to talk about the Ryan Reynolds kiss with?
I don't care. When straight people try to pretend to be gay, it's not to me.
But when they're as beautiful
Renee, what's the worst?
I loved it. I loved the little. It was
Spider-Man kissing Deadpool.
Okay, so I think the worst. Well, I don't know. It's a tie between, let's see, Olivia Coppola.
Wait. Coupo.
Coupo. I mean, this to me looked like it was like she should be at El Coyote serving margaritas.
I will
right?
say in yes. person when she was I mean, when she walked down that carpet, everyone was trying to take pictures of it because it flowed so beautifully.
Really? So
it
just, the movement was great.
The movement huh? was great. She looked like she was in a
I thought her makeup gown. and hair looked really great, but I just thought it's just too much going on. I don't know, but that was just me. So what do I know? This is Zuhair Mourad. He does a lot of great things. So Sofia Vergara wears a lot of
hair. I will say it walked well.
Wait a minute. Yeah.
What?
Which I went Sofia Vergara.
Vergara? Yeah, she was in Zuhair Mourad as well. Did you like that or
she
no?
She looked vulgar, I thought.
Yeah.
So, too much boob.
Too much boob.
See, now we're
back. So, see, that's where we're at, though. Boob like, if you see, if you have the boobs, you can't.
We've gone full circle. See, this is what
so
I was talking about.
So hard to be
right?
an actress.
Right?
It really is.
But here's too the much, thing. It's like,
she why are we talking about
boob,
John Travolta's
too
boobs?
Boob.
Let's talk about that hair piece, huh? What about that?
I'm sure at this point it's plugs.
You think it's plugs?
I'm at this point.
You think he has any hair left?
Well, from somewhere. Yeah. It's growing other places.
They pull it off his back or something, right? Yeah. So that was the Zuhair Mourad, but you didn't like the Sofia Vergara? Is that the one you want to talk about?
No. Okay. And, like, she was so vulgar, I thought. Yeah.
Well, wait, I want to get to that one there because you thought that was one of the worst ones?
Yeah.
Oh, again, I really? Love, in person especially, I loved
this
it.
This looked like,
you
this
like
was,
this?
That she
it
took
it. Like
Janelle Monáe.
She borrowed it from her teenage cousin who didn't want to wear it to the prom. That's what it looks like to me, right?
She was trying too hard. She's like, this is my first time, and so I have to do
but
this.
But it's not.
I don't know. I just
maybe this would look
so
good at the Grammys, you know?
Yeah, I could see that.
This would look good at the Grammys.
I could see maybe it wasn't the best Golden Globes dress, but I thought it was really fun. And I love
it's
that
whimsical,
she's actually and she's
right?
also this is her first foray into wearing dresses. She is somebody that was very adamant about having a uniform. She only wears black and white.
Yep.
And she used to only wear pants or shorts. Mm-hmm. She would never wear dresses. And so in the last year
she's so cute and quirky and I work
she
with
just
her
can do no wrong in my mind. I love her. I loved her in Moonlight too. She was
great.
Fantastic in Moonlight.
Yeah.
And her
she's great in Hidden
who's
Figures.
Who's this?
Janelle Monáe.
Only wears black and white. Won't wear dresses.
She was the
she's like an Oreo
she was the
cookie.
Drug dealer's girlfriend in Moonlight.
Oh. You mean Naomi Hers as a
black person? Is that where you're going?
I don't remember.
We're being fabulous. So let's actually
so then,
talk about
this one.
Okay, we'll do this and then let's
okay.
Sarah Paulson.
Oh my God! Okay,
and
this looked like Laura Bush to me. This looked like she looks so matronly.
I was so
and
confused.
She's too young. She's looks. She's
Colin
too young
Taylor.
To look.
She's
right.
probably like, what does
but
it look like?
But they never hang out. So but Patrick,
don't you think
you
she's too young to look
of,
like this?
Of People Magazine.
I think this is
matronly. They really
like
don't hang
hair
out
either.
Yeah, the
I
hair
was just
very.
I mean, I just think that when they do, I just think when they do, they're private. I mean, I've seen them in moments. She's taken her to things before, and they've been adorable.
But Colin's doing the play, and
I mean, they make it work. I mean, you're sitting here to somebody that also has worked with her.
Looks like
she's
Laura
an
Bush.
Old soul. I mean, you know,
I don't know. This is something like an 80-year-old woman.
I can't comment on this.
I mean, Joan Collins
close.
Doesn't wear things like this, you know? This is like an
it's
old lady
terrible
dress.
Terrible
outfit. Yeah. It's like, yeah, right?
I think
the hair, too. Is like, she just looked like womp.
I think
nobody
said it right there. It fits her personality. She is an old soul. She is somebody
How about Felicity Jones? What about that? I mean, that was just like that. Talking about another matronly thing.
Wait, I want to get your opinion really fast on, and I don't know if you can recall the outfits in mind, but I think that she's actually been the best dress she's ever been in the last year or so is Felicity Huffman. And
oh,
I don't know.
Yeah.
Like, she has
look
looked
good. Yeah.
She looked good last night. She looked great at the Emmys. I thought that she was one of the best dressed at the Emmys. Like,
I thought Brie Larson looked fantastic, too.
Oh, yeah, you're right. She really did.
I thought she looked amazing.
Not a fan
night.
Of her, but she looked good.
Who are you a fan of?
You.
Who are your favorite?
Anyway, you guys,
how much fun do we have, huh? This is always kicks and giggles, right?
I have to say, so can you flash up? I'll be at Rockwell.
Oh, okay.
January 30th.
I'll be there too. What a coincidence.
In fact, my friend from People Magazine, Patrick Gomez, is singing a duet with me and a solo, whatever. So go to Rockwell, LA.
What are you singing?
Oh, I'm doing the whole show.
Oh, okay.
He's in for a few.
Yeah,
we're
just,
doing
just a few.
Gotta Get a Gimmick, but we're opening with All That Jazz.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you like to give everything away.
Oh, okay. And then he's going to do a solo. Patrick has an
I would share it, but I haven't decided what it is exactly yet.
Do you like how his voice got really
loose? Yeah.
I'm very serious now.
I have to thank our panel. As usual, we really didn't even, like, cover. Like, we just
I love the opening number. The rest of it was meh. There we go.
Kate, and then where can people find you?
Okay, start with somebody else. What do you mean by that? Sorry.
Like social media.
Oh, social media. Sorry.
We'll start here. Patrick, definitely,
pick up any issue of People Magazine or go to people.com. You'll find my name. But
can I be honest? My mom loves you. She looks for your name before she reads a People Magazine. Mom, hey, girl.
Hey, she rolls her eyes.
Hello, Mamala.
Oh, Mom, thank you.
Hi.
Is it true? How many times you tell me how cute Patrick Gomez is?
Yes.
Well, I appreciate it. The feeling is mutual. Thank you. But yeah, no, pick up one of those. You'll find my name in there. At Patrick Gomez LA, as in Los Angeles. And that's Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all of it.
Awesome. Naomi.
Naomi W. Grossman. Ooh. Across all platforms.
What's the W?
Oh, it's my mysterious middle name.
Wonder.
Ooh.
Wonder.
It's actually Welshman.
It's actually Wright. Oh. I am Wright.
Yes, you
damn
are.
Damn it, it's my middle name.
And I'll tell you, if you can take Naomi out for a drink, do it.
Yeah.
Renee, where can our listeners find
you? You can find me on Facebook as just my name, Rene Horsch, H-O-R-S-C-H. Rene is with one E. If you see two, that usually means female.
He's and gearing then, up for his own show, by the way. Like, this is like an E show.
and then on Instagram, it's Rene_Horsch, pretty basic. And then go to markzunino.com, Z-U-N-I-N-O, Mark with a K, and you can check out all of the celebrities that we dress, and we just built a new website. It's pretty amazing, so it's some cool stuff. Yeah.
Great.
Thank you.
Okay. Kate. Yes.
Welcome to LA. This is awesome.
Yeah. Welcome to Hollywood.
So, I am at Kate_Kneeland on Twitter and Kate_Kneeland on Instagram.
N-E-A-L?
So, come on. No, it's actually K-N-E-E-L-A-N-D.
Ooh, she's fancy. I love it. Wow.
Yes.
Follow her because she's going to post pictures from the premiere tomorrow.
I am. Yes, please.
Fun. Where is it?
It's going to be at the Arc Light.
Okay.
Cool. Oh, nice.
Very close to where we are right now.
Yes, we love. We love. So. Kurt, thank you as always.
Kurt, you're the man.
Thank you, Kurt.
Oh.
Do you close with a pun?
Okay, I guess this is something new we're going to do. Come see me at Rockwell. I have a bevy of stars joining me.
And me.
Kurt, can you close us out with a pun?
Yeah, I will.
Oh, God. You guys, this would be so bad.
I have a friend who tells me a lot of bird puns. I realized that two can't play at that game.
Oh! Sasa! Thank you, Mama Rose. Thank you, Kurt. Thank you, our listeners on iHeartRadio. We will see you next week. Come see me at Rockwell.
Woo! Hey!
This has been On the Rocks with Alexander every Tuesday at 7 p.m. on Universal Broadcasting Network. Find me on Facebook on the Rocks Radio Show. Tweet me or Instagram me at On the Rocks On Air. See you next Tuesday!